In winning the French Open, Novak Djokovic achieved a record-breaking 23rd Grand Slam title. A feat all the more remarkable, as few marked out Djokovic in the early stages of his career as having the potential to become an all-time great. Even Novak himself had doubts. Indeed, by January 2010, following a quarter-final defeat at the Australian Open to Joe Wilfried Tsonga, Djokovic himself questioned whether he had the stamina to last the pace. A Serbian doctor by the name of Igor Cetijevic noticed Djokovic's travails and reached out to his compatriot in the wake of that grueling defeat to Tsonga. To this day, Djokovic attributes his longevity in the sport to Cetijevic. But who is Dr. Cetijevic? And what was the advice he gave Djokovic that made him so admired by the future record breaker? Some of the doctor's methods have been questioned. And Djokovic's stance on COVID, as well as vaccines, has been attributed to his faith in Cetijevic. What cannot be questioned, however, is the influence the doctor had on what was arguably the biggest turning point in Djokovic's tennis career.
Next morning, I have coffee with my friend who told me about the match, and he told me, no, I lost match now because he's asthma. He says, not asthma, something else. And that's what I first teach him is how to eat. I said, he's always actually, his nature has kind of this gear to learn. Okay. And I said, just to provide what I know about life and beyond. Okay. Mm-hmm. I just provide him information or what I think could be and said, try for a while and see it. Okay. And then just applying better and better, better and better. And all of our jobs start to blossom, you know, and Noel explode. You know, that year was 42 matches, I think, was in a row.
Yes.
Well, it's not a virus at first at all. Okay, that's we call it a virus, but it's not. Okay, we're talking about something which is man-made stuff. Okay, and it's not a virus.
Is Novak of the belief that it's not a virus and that it's also man-made as well?
Ready. Play.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, whatever time it is in the world, wherever you are tuning in from. Today I am joined by Igor Cetijevic. We had a little practice of the pronunciation of his name, and probably okay. I did it correctly in the bit before we.
It's close enough. It's okay.
Right. We're going to stick with Igor from now on, anyway. Mm-hmm. Igor, first of all, tell us about who you are.
Okay, who am I? It's kind of a philosophical question. I'm kind of a medical practitioner. I'm a medical doctor and doing different kind of therapies in my practice. I spread my knowledge in alternative medicine also after my university. And I'm doing kind of acupuncture, myotherapy, biofeedback, nutrition, suggestions, counseling, different kind of approaches toward the health of any person.
When you say alternative medicine, can you give us some examples?
But that's what I mentioned. Biofeedback is one of them. Chinese traditional medicine is one of them. Herbalism is one of them. It's just kind of like not mainstream only treatments, because we have official medicine and we have out-of-box medicine too. Okay, that's kind of like seeing people holistically, seeing bigger picture. Not only prescribing medicine.
When you say alternatives, so that means, you know, that you are not suggesting that, for example, surgery or any conventional ways of fixing our body, these are not entirely ruled out or ignored, right?
No, that's kind of, medicine is obviously one, you know, but we have different approaches, you know, that's kind of like, we can't separate medicine to be left, right, up and down, you know, that's medicine is one. Looking for the best options for patient to offer them. Of course, if somebody have traffic accident, we need to go in first aid to fix somebody, you know, and to provide healing and everything later on. But it's necessary to do it in medical hospitals and so on. But other things like nutrition, like counseling, like magnetic therapies, like physiotherapies, you know, you can do it differently.
Sure.
Okay.
And when did you first become aware of Novak Djokovic? For me, as a tennis fan, it would have been around about 2004, 2005.
Okay, I'm not kind of big tennis fan at all. You know, I just follow. Okay. By coincidence, I watched one match in Australia 2010, I think.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine actually pushed me to see it because he told me, he said, "One, the Serbian guy, as you are doing, kind of like very well, kind of is young, very dominant, and so on." And I saw this match. I think it was quarterfinal or semifinal. I really forgot, against Novak and Tsonga. And okay, it was after lunch for me here, relaxing and watching, and you know, a little bit sleeping, a little bit watching. Okay, but commentator mentioned there during one break, but was a medical break, I think, kind of Novak Djokovic has asthma. Okay. And for me, it was start to be interesting to observe this match, you know, to see what's going on there. And it was kind of a few times he repeated, and I know Novak was very good on the beginning, but by second set, he declined the energies and medical again appearing. And I can read a little bit about the language, okay, there. And I'm seeing something is not right what they're talking about. Okay, I have my doubts, okay, about what is there. Because generally, asthma appearing in the morning, not afternoon. Match was afternoon. Okay, and I a little bit loudly comment, it's not asthma, you know. And my wife, she's an American, you know, very open-minded person. I said, "What's going on there?" I said, "Well, one match." And so I explained a little bit. And commentator mentioning all time, is asthma. I think it's not asthma, it's something else. I said, "Who is this?" I said, "Well, a Serbian guy." Okay, why not go to help him? Okay, kind of like go there to help him, you know, that's kind of what's communication. Next morning, I have coffee with my friend who told me about match, and he told me, "No, I lost match, you know, because he's asthma." He says, "Not asthma, it's something else." And as we are Serbians, we are all connected between each other, you know, and he said, "Okay, I know somebody, maybe, you know, I'll make contact for, you know, to help him, you know, this." I said, "Okay, fine." And really, that's happened after a while. And his father called me and said, "Okay, would you like to help Novak a little bit, you know, because we're looking for some answers and somehow he had issue with breathing and allergies and asthma and so on." Blah, blah, blah. And that's okay. Let's go to see it, you know. And we met each other. And that was kind of like, for me, first time introduction for tennis, big sport time, you know.
This is in the few weeks after Australian Open 2010.
Not a few weeks, but let's say first connection happened somewhere in the springtime. It was a Davis Cup match between Serbia and Croatia. Okay, somewhere, okay. I think April. I'm not sure. And that's how we met for the first time. And Novak is a very nice guy, and all people in the team was nice people around him, and all, and they just kind of say, "Okay, who you are?" Okay, that's, they ask me who you are, what to do. Okay, and a little bit talk about myself briefly. I don't like to talk a lot, but say, "Well, let's go to see what it's all about, you know, what is the cause of your condition?" Okay, or what is the causes of your condition, which is better to say.
And you said you wanted to reach out to him. Sorry, you said you wanted to reach out to him, but I mean, was that easy to communicate? Did you have any encouragement even sort of before? Did you hear anything that Novak had said either before that Tsonga match or after it? Or were you just determined to get in touch?
I wasn't determined at all. My friends, they were determined, you know, but they kind of pushed me to, you know, I have my good life, you know, and doing my life here in Cyprus. I'm not so people who follow sports on TV. Okay, that's right. For me, TV is a foreign thing, you know. But when people telling me, "Okay, some match, whatever, okay, let's go to see it, I can see it," but not kind of that I'm driven to see it. Okay. But my friends there, they know what I'm doing, kind of unusual way of checkups and treatments, and they push me. Okay. And I said, "Okay, let's go to experience this world." It was kind of like a challenge for me, too. And when I met him, you know, I seen this very nice guy, you know, and open to succeed, you know, I'm very, very, very strong determination to succeed. And I explained him that health is like puzzle game. Let's go to see all puzzles together. Okay. And from physical, mental, emotional, social, environmental, genetics, all these things create who we are. Okay. And I start to a little bit present him my way of thinking and doing things. And we start with simple things with nutrition, But key, I think it was key for a lot of sport people, is what they eat and how they eat. Okay, not what they eat. It's kind of very easy to find out, you know, we can check it and so on, but how they eat. Okay, that's mean they have no time to eat, particularly new generation. All time is like this, okay, telephones and eating, you know, the splitting on physical, mental, emotional body, okay, the eating under stress. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of key, because it can be the best food on the world, okay, for you. And if it's under stress, coming in system who is not prepared, okay, and you don't even chew properly, you just swallow like animal, you know, food, which is sometimes strong food to digest, coming in unprepared stomach, mm-hmm. again, could digest, coming in intestines, and food rotting there. And it's ideal base for build up infections, bugs, parasites, inflammations, whatever. Okay, and that's what I first teach him, is how to eat. I said, take telephone out of your table. Okay, that's don't be like a lion. Take your antelope, eat in a bush until you finish. Don't touch anything. Okay, mm-hmm. And he picked up this my little suggestions from the beginning. And okay, that's I teach him life, actually, what is life around. Okay, and I'm seeing as we start to work a little bit, you know, there is major puzzles to work on. Okay, and as I start to learn about tennis a little bit, okay, what is around, and how is pace, preparations, you know, trainings, and I'm seeing kind of a lot of gaps that are there. Okay, and I just kind of gave my opinion and said, okay, if match for your, you know, match your way of thinking and so on, take it and apply for a while. You will see results working for you or not. And that's how we start to be kind of like for a while together. And he start to benefits and he start to sleep better. Okay. And I realize somebody who is already on top in tennis doesn't sleep really well. Okay. And he told me, I didn't know it. Okay. And he said, Doc, I'm sleeping now in one piece.
Okay.
Because he start to eat properly, you know, eliminate this tension, stress during the meals and so on. And body have time to relax. Key for every sportman is to sleep, to have good sleep, to rejuvenate, to recuperate. Okay, because it's kind of under pressure and everything, adrenaline is buzzing inside, you know, and eating wrong and bad, you know, and they need 2-3 days to recover. But if you have good pace and good proper food, good nutrition, good environment, that's something else.
Was he drinking alcohol at this stage, by the way?
He never drink alcohol.
Never. Okay, he's never drunk alcohol.
Only maybe sometimes kind of like a little bit show off, kind of like somebody give him glass, he can go cheers, but he never drink alcohol. He's pure sportsman, you know, he's very, very cautious about it.
Okay. And so this is 2010. Did you meet him regularly, like every week, every month, telephone call?
We decide, when we start to kind of work first month, okay, I said, well, let's go now to observe what it's all about. Okay, and that's kind of for me to get depth of what's going on there. And I start to see this, as I mentioned, I see things holistically. Okay, physical body, mental body, social body, environment around, you know, all the creating all these good or bad things for us, even spiritual patterns. Okay, environment mean radiation. Okay. Now we're having kind of big time, not only in sport, anywhere. A lot of radiations around us, bombarding us all the time. Officially, it's not good for us, but nobody cares about it. Okay, but I'm seeing daily patients, they suffer too much telephones around, too much antennas around. Okay, they have not any particular reason to be sick, but kind of they have headaches, they have lack of, you know, sleep, insomnia, hormones, everything. Okay, but when you teach young people to not keep telephones next to them when they sleep, they get benefits. To switch off router before they go in sleep, benefits. Okay, that's simple things like teaching people, you know, to gain their own health, and altogether creating, you know, good picture.
So did you go watch matches as well with
yeah,
him?
Yeah, I was 1 year with him, you know, that's from actually when I was seeing, when I started to learn more about tennis, what's going on there and what is his goal. Okay, he was third the time on ATP list, you know, and well, he's straight, I think, kind of determination, and he's very, he's always actually, his nature has kind of this gear to learn. Okay, and I just to provide what I know about life and beyond. Okay, mm-hmm. I just provide him information or what I think could be, and said try for a while and see it. Okay, and he's very good for it, you know. So don't give any judgment on beginning. Information is here, what how I'm seeing it, apply it, work on it, and so on. And he start to be better and better, and health wise, which is key for every sportsman to be healthy, happy, and strong. And later on, we can work on other stuff around him, you know, and in him, and he was happy with this. Okay, and I said, okay, doc, would you like to work with me for longer? Okay, let's go. What is your goal? I said, I like to be best on the road to win a Grand Slam. And I said, how many Grand Slams you have per year? I have no idea, trust me. Mm-hmm. And all in teams, all people in teams said, come on, Doc, you don't know how many Grand Slams you... He said, I have no idea, I have no clue, guys, you know, that's mm-hmm. my new field for me. Mm-hmm. And they told me I have four major and one last big at the end of the year. I said, well,
yeah,
okay, I'm good, you are good, you are good, you are good, kind of four of us in team. You know, this guy who playing is kind of excellent. He can do effort, okay, and he will run the minimum three Grand Slams this year. I said, do you know what you're talking about? Three Grand Slams per year. I said, okay, okay. If you don't believe in yourself, you know, that's how can we achieve goals, you know? And really, mm-hmm. we start to work like team very well. In the beginning, it was kind of like a little bit tune up, but on the end, we start to understand the positions of everybody. And okay, and he exploded those three Grand Slams that year. Okay, and on the end, he win this Wimbledon first time, and he was very happy to get first place on ATP list, and was kind of dream become true.
Tell us about what he was eating before and what he sort of changed in his diet.
He eating like a bird, you know, that's kind of like he had no time to eat, okay, just going okay. around, you know, whatever he's grasping, you know, in a cafeteria or in a restaurant and so on. As the muscle people do, and that was a surprise for me. People that we know, like big names in tennis, okay, they have no clue about nutrition or how to eat and when to eat. They have no time. Just go in cafeteria, orange juice, coffee, steaks, eggs, salads, everything in the same time, you know, boom, you know. It's just kind of like foreign language for body, okay. And that they are eating under stress, they're rushing all the time. And of course, they're damaging normal metabolism of body. And manifest later on, you can see even today a lot of tennis players with these flusters on shoulders, you know, on legs and whatever. Okay, that's actually helped me to understand what's going on there, because I know Chinese medicine very well. I studied this for 3 years. Actually, meridian of large intestine is here on the shoulder, front shoulder. Okay, okay. Large intestine, of course, is here physically, but this projection, when you're doing acupuncture meridians, therapies, putting needles and so on, is stimulating this meridian to stimulate large intestine. But example, eating rubbish, we having rubbish intestines, and these highways getting blocked. We're a little bit pushing with tennis, whatever, or handball, or whatever, you know, and we're getting these injuries. That's how it's happened. Mm-hmm. And he was full of flusters when I met him, but when we finished, it was no fluster. Okay. Because we start to clear out body from these toxins, okay, which they're building up. Okay, imagine now putting in good car wrong petrol, okay, mm-hmm. little bit, 1 liter mm-hmm. diesel in Ferrari, okay, and pushing a kind of big race and so on. Of course, engine will break somewhere or something will happen inside. That's the same in body. But I'm happy that he was very open to talk about it, okay, because people, they kind of keeping this kind of top secret stuff. But he was very open to talk about the change in nutrition and so on, to big awareness of people. Even today, that's 12 years ago happened, they work with him. Okay, even people today contact me and asking me for advice and directions and so on.
You're still in touch?
Yeah, time to time, yes. And I sent him kind of messages time to time, kind of when I'm seeing some match. Okay, that's when I'm kind of exposed to, but I'm not kind of big TV guy, I told you. I see him kind of like in news, you know, and sometimes happening there. I tell him congratulations, and because his dreams, they are to be on top and to do all the best. And I'm happy when he's winning, you know, because knowing him, he's a good guy, you know, and have a good heart and doing a lot of charity work and helping other people. That's kind of amazing what he's doing around. But he's not kind of like ego trip guy, you know, me. Okay. He also giving a lot of people around in Serbia or in the Balkans or anywhere.
Tell us about the diet that you introduced then. What would a typical day or 3-day diet be from morning till sleep?
Well, I don't like the word diet at all.
Okay.
Because diet is a very abused word in the world of commercialism and so on. I like to eat proper food.
Okay,
proper food. What is proper for me doesn't mean proper for you. And otherwise, we need to find out what is your engine working on. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm putting like pictures. If it's your engine working on diesel, you put diesel inside. You cannot put different petrol. You cannot mix up because it's cheaper or something. Okay. Because somebody else is doing so and so. Okay. And using also pictures for people to understand better, to understand they are all unique, all different. Okay. And uniqueness, when you find your uniqueness, what your uniqueness need, that's key. Okay. And generally providing diets, let's say starting morning so and so, starting morning, da, 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 it's not the same like me and you and somebody else. Okay. Could be similarities. Okay. But we need to find out what is basics. Basics actually is alive food. Live food giving life. That's the veggies and fruits. Okay. They're vibrant. We talk about today sports supplements, sport drinks, and so on. It's rubbish. Okay. That's kind of like we're talking about live food giving you to vibrate. Okay. Life food giving you life. Okay. Giving you fast recuperation and nourishment. All the supplements there is like called secondhand food. Okay. If you like to be secondhand healthy, go forward. Okay. But if you like to get first division of health, you know, you need to go to with your nice, let's say, smoothies, mix of smoothies, okay, let's put some nuts inside, put some nice cinnamon to give good, nice taste, and cinnamon is good for promoting circulation and so on. So if you are not allergic on yogurt, put some yogurt on it, good probiotics, okay. That's what you're giving you life force in the morning.
Okay. All right, guys, good morning. This is how I start off my day, preparing a smoothie that will help me fight off the stress, give my body enough nutrients. There's a lot of stuff there, a lot of minerals, a lot of vitamins, antioxidants, anti-inflammatories, good sources of omega-3. And I encourage you to take care of what you eat and stay healthy.
Okay, not kind of steak, eggs, and so on. and orange juice on the end and coffee, you know. That's totally different energies coming in body. But key is to bless meal. That's biggest spice for meal is to bless meal, to calm your mind, in other words.
Okay.
And everybody benefits. All my patients today know my stories. Okay. That's coming to me and say, well, tell me about diet. Well, forget diet. How you eat. Explain a little bit. Okay. And that's actually,
When you say bless the meal, what do you mean? Just take it
bless
easy.
Meal. No, not just to be aware. Okay, that's an example in this moment as we talk now. How many people in this world have no chance to choose or to have food? A lot. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. And we are in position as human being to understand that we are blessed at the moment to have choice even. We can choose even food, you know. Okay, we can choose organic whatever, smoothies and so on. Okay, and to be aware that the human being you'll bring out your spirituality on higher level, okay, to be aware, to kind of like throw food in yourself. Blessing meal, you don't have to be a particularly religious person to understand, to be aware, okay? To be aware, actually, you start to be aligning your physical, mental, emotional, spiritual body to work together. Because you are not only meat and bones, we have our mental life, we have emotional life, we have spiritual life, and all together create us together, okay? That's what is my job, to teach people these little puzzles and how to maintain them. Okay. And Nole was exceptionally good student. Okay. Mm-hmm. And he was very, he had a kind of good determination to learn. Okay. And then mm-hmm. I just provide him knowledge and he apply knowledge and getting better and better and better. And today is amazing. Okay. 36, yeah. Looking like a boy 26, you know, yeah. in physical body and mentally and very clear mind and a nice family, lovely kids around, you know, that's just kind of beautiful, beautiful man to see, you know, that kind of he did something amazing.
You worked with him for a year quite closely?
Exactly a year. Let's say April, and we finish Wimbledon time is by like now next year.
Yeah, so just and over
it's kind
a
of
year.
Too much for me to travel, you know. It's kind of like, okay, I like to travel to have fun, but not to travel to stay in hotels and to be with two.
So you were
guys
traveling with him to a lot of the tournaments in that 13,
yes, 14 Yes, all year, actually, all year round.
Okay.
And just so observing what's happening. For example, we're going hotel there, you know, any hotels, you know, that's and I'm checking also energy when he sleep. Okay, that's because we have all this Wi-Fi rubbish around, and if his energy around us very bad, you know, we cannot sleep at all. You know, that's, and I'm checking these things, you know, and suggesting where to sleep, but where to put his bed, you know. That's sometimes he's moving bed to a crazy corner. Okay, but he sleep well. Okay. And I'm checking a kitchen also, you know, regarding food and all what they have. Sometimes not always good option, but I can run in some markets, organic food, and make some juices and so on. I actually was good bonding also between us, the whole team. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I'm making, you know, like in breakfast in my room, you know, and I put my little blender, and I'm making smoothies for all of them, you know, putting the little messages on this paper cups, you know, and they're waiting for them, you know. They're coming and they're laughing like crazy in the morning. We start laughing in the morning, and everybody's looking, what's going on here? Okay. But when you're laughing, you're creating hormones, which they are positive hormones, serotonin. Okay. And serotonin eliminating insecurity. that's most of young people have, you know, expectation of match, too much in head, and so on. And that's kind of like.
Who was his coach at that time? Was it Marion Vida?
Vida.
And
yes.
What was Marion's sort of attitude to these?
Excellent. Vida is actually one of these. I call it a fuse in high power. You know, when electricity kind of going high, and Marion is there. Okay, because it's under pressure, everything else. You know, and energy going up and so on. And now you have somebody who is always fused. You know, it doesn't allow things to happen out of control.
Okay.
And when I met him first time, you know, he was very nice and a nice old time, but that time was particular. I said, well, Doc, we have no idea what you're doing. Can you explain us a little bit to get an idea? Mm-hmm. What is your there kind of biofeedback, acupuncture, whatever, you know? And we sit together and I discuss and let's give some little bit of advice and directions and knowledge and experience. And I said, guys, I have no clue about tennis. Teach me about tennis. Okay. About the rules and how it's going on there, and da, da, da. And they start to exchange information with full respect, you know, because I don't like to put nobody down. I'm a big doctor, you know, and nobody knows what I'm talking about, but I can learn from you what you need. Okay, what is your kind of training, how your training session, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, okay, when you're eating, how you're eating, and all these little things I can see through talking with team, and we exchange data very fast. We have our meetings, which is very nice. Okay, we can see gaps, what we can make better. And we're just walking and talking, okay, and then just applying better and better, better and better. And all of our jobs start to blossom, you know, and not explode. You know, that year was 42 matches, I think, was in a row.
Yes, something like that, yeah. Unbeaten, yeah. Yeah. And so Marion, did Marion try any of these sort of, did he adapt his diet as well?
Yes, everybody adapted, everybody getting healthy. When I was around, everybody started to be healthy. Okay, because okay. I'm influencer with good health. Okay, and if you're around me, you need to follow me, or you are lost. No, maybe junk or something. You know, but when knowledge that to be better, and Marian that to be better, Gigi and our Roger, our physio, you know, and they start to ask own advice, you know, private advice. Okay, so I'm here. Okay, guys, so let's go to use my knowledge and to everybody to be happy, okay, and mm-hmm. healthy. And if we are all happy and healthy, of course we can provide our happiness and health toward the Novak, okay, and that's how it happened. And healthy atmosphere, let's say. Okay.
And so from about summer 2011, what was the conversation with Novak at this point? Was it his decision? Was it yours? How did the sort of movement away from him, or separation, if that's what it was?
It wasn't in a healthy way, because his goal was to achieve this Wimbledon, to be top and to be ATP listed, to his dream to bring cup of Wimbledon, you know. So okay, that's a goal, let's go to focus on this goal. but also I have my private life. Okay, that's my practice is here was a little bit suffering because I was all time here. Come and go is not a good idea for my patients around. And when you finish, oh, it was kind of nice. Goodbye, see you, good luck. If you need some support, let me know. Okay, and I will always offer because that's me. Okay, whatever I will do it. Okay, even this example in Australia happened this mess in Australia recently.
Novak Djokovic touched down safely, but hit turbulence when he tried to clear customs.
Rules are rules, and there are no special cases.
The world number one was detained by Border Force officers as his vaccine exemption was examined.
Novak Djokovic, the world's top-ranked men's tennis player, has been ordered to leave Australia.
It's fair to say that this whole incident is just not a good look for tennis or for Djokovic.
The Serbian president labelled the intervention harassment of the world's best tennis player, saying Serbia would fight for justice and truth.
I came here tonight because I heard that Novak is here at the airport, but he's not allowed to come to Australia, which is really disappointing.
Just a day earlier, Djokovic announced he'd been granted permission to play in the Australian Open. It quickly became clear a medical exemption ticked off by the Victorian government wasn't enough for the Commonwealth.
He was unable to furnish that proof to the Border Force officers at the airport last night.
Both governments are now arguing over who's to blame.
The Commonwealth issue the visas. We determine who then gets to play in that tournament.
As he waited for answers on his status, it's understood Djokovic spent much of the day at an immigration detention hotel in inner Melbourne.
This mess in Australia recently when he was in this hotel closed there, And I encouraged him, okay, I told him, it's a great experience. And everybody in the world said, wow. I said, no, that's a great experience.
Did you speak to him then during this?
I sent him just a message, of encouragement, not kind of long story. But he said, well, that's kind of a great experience. You have beautiful subjects for a new chapter of your book, To be in the jail, like first in the world. And all this nonsense is about the COVID, what's happening, 2 years, and he handled very well, with his strength and belief system, which is I'm very proud of it. Okay, that's to have opinion, to become like follower. Okay, and now all civilization suffer from this today, because we were followers of certain ideas.
The more you touch upon COVID and the more recent times, I mean, what is your attitude to, first of all, the virus, but also, secondly, vaccines?
Well, it's not the virus first at all. Okay, that's we call it virus, but it's not. Okay, we're talking about something which is man-made stuff. Okay, and it's not virus.
Okay. Does Novak believe that too?
Okay, and all this word of vaccination is not vaccination. Okay, that's experiment. Okay, that's kind of, we know it now. We can kind of like say, if I know, that I will never do it. Well, no, under pressure, what's happening? People react differently. That's your choice. And in the end, we always have choice. Okay, that's, you can be in jail, you can be anywhere, but you have choice to be a good man, okay, and a good person. Okay, you can put anywhere. You can be in the best position in your life, but you have choice. Okay, if you have a belief system, okay, just follow it. Okay, and be ready for consequences or people not accepting you or be against you or whatever. But if you have your belief system, which is clear, pure, and you're connected with higher dimensions, that's it.
Is Novak of the belief that it's not a virus and that it's also man-made as well?
I think so.
Yeah.
I never discussed this subject regarding what could be, but I'm sure it's not good for him and for his body because he's the healthiest person in the world, I think, and who invests a lot of time to be healthy and one little stuff to put in body and compromise body and all career to be jeopardy. I don't think so is idea, but you can see proof now these days because you are in sport. Okay, how many consequences, how many people have issues with vaccines, young people, 20 years old, sportsmen collapsing on fields, that's shame.
Is this all vaccines, Igor, or more specifically the COVID one?
That's not all, because vaccines, they are vaccines. COVID, this is experimental stuff. Okay, it's two stories. When I was a small boy, we have vaccines, is only one thing. Okay, inside we have little adjuvants, mean the triggering inflammation in the body, la la la, it's the body reacting on it and building up immunity. But as time passed, we have been kind of triple, we have pentavalent vaccines, mean five different bugs putting in a little body, okay, today. And we have enormous explosion of allergies, okay, in the last decades. Okay, every single kid has some allergy, something. Okay, not only you can blame pollen or dust or milk or gluten, you know, because we're compromising immune system with bombas in body. Okay, and that's kind of big, big money, and the big pharma like make big money. I'm not against vaccines, but what's going on now is business. Okay, that's what is unfortunately truth in our medicine.
During the sort of COVID lockdown period of 2020, at least, Novak did some interesting Instagram live videos, including one with a guru who suggested, or actually Novak suggested to the guru, that he, through the power of mind, he could change polluted water into drinkable water, and same with toxic foods. Do you believe that too?
And to a certain point, yes. Okay, but everything what is in media said, it always is kind of out of context. Okay, and we need to see bigger picture there. Okay, there. That's example. Now you're drinking water. If you're under stress, this water will come in stress system. If you are happy, okay, and relaxed, and drinking same water, will be other reflection body. Okay, that's state of mind is very important. State of mind and spirit and mental, emotional body and spiritual, but they're aligned. Okay. An example, if you're drinking with consciousness and love, is you create different vibrations around you. Example, if I'm now angry and talking to you angry, how you feel? Okay. You'll reflect on it. Okay. And when drinking this water next to you, they reflect too. But imagine only now that our body is about 75-80% which is water. Okay, and this water has memory. Okay, and when we're having, when you're blessing it, same water, okay, and drinking before it, that's getting a vibration of you, okay, of blessing. Blessing is around you, your etherical body working, okay, body memorizing it and feeding you. Okay, that's if you're going like other word, let's say religion, we have holy waters. Okay, why they are holy? Okay. Why? Because the energy is changed inside, you know. That's kind of like people that, intentional people that toward this water is different, okay? And interaction is different.
Okay, whether you think COVID was man-made or even whether it was a virus or not, would you say that it was contagious? So, you know, if I have it then, and I'm in the same room as you, I mean, you believe it exists, right? COVID, you believe it existed, albeit...
Of course, it exists, but kind of like is under a hidden umbrella, what is all about, okay? Of course, if you can see just a little bit of open window and time, look at sky, what's going on there, okay? The chemtrails, okay, happening, and what is in chemtrails? When we put children, nobody have them, never see them, okay? Okay, I'm a little bit older than you. Did you remember chemtrails in childhood? Okay, I don't think so. But now you can see a little bit up, time to time spraying. Okay, we have kind of climate story. But what is in chemtrails? Okay, nobody talking about it. Mm-hmm. It's top secret stuff. Okay.
But regarding COVID more specifically, and you did recognize that whatever it was, it did exist, and that it could be passed on from one person to another. Mm-hmm. Therefore, what were your thoughts when you saw Novak with, you know, when he was COVID positive and hanging out with children and a journalist, etc.? Mm-hmm. Did you think that was responsible?
Very, very responsible. Because of knowing a little bit medicine, we understand.
Responsible or irresponsible?
Responsible. Okay. Because you think is it this bug is this man-made bug is away? No, it's around us all the time. It will be around us, but it's potency dropping down. Okay, and now going out, inhaling particles, somebody exhale who is COVID positive, of course you will get some particles that you're reacting on. Okay, but it's the most natural way you will react on it. Okay, through your mucous membranes in your lungs and your body will respond because your immune will immediately on beginning recognize something is wrong. Okay, and creating a reaction which is not extremely bad. Okay, but kind of like getting directly in the blood, okay, through the injection, I don't think so that's a good idea. Okay,
when was the last time you spoke to Novak?
Oh, I cannot remember now.
Even via a message or WhatsApp? Or
I cannot remember this now, just really got in our discussion.
Okay. And what about the asthma?
I sent him a message when he winning matches, you know, and losing matches. It was Roland Garros, I think. When he won, I sent him a message. Okay, congrats, you know, because the big match and so that's it.
And what about the asthma nowadays?
Excuse me?
The asthma that we spoke about at the beginning.
Yeah, but it's nothing. It's because it's kind of... All is because it's kind of a wrong comment, okay? That's because kind of like I'm seeing that as knowing through the Chinese medicine, lung time is in morning. If you have compromised health in lungs, and lungs we have maximum energy in the morning, and we're getting asthma in the morning most of the time. But the match was afternoon, okay?
Got it.
And actually, it was issue of wrong food, okay, before match. Okay, and imagine now, again, Chinese medicine, large intestines and lungs working together energetically. And if you have toxins in large intestines, lungs getting compromised. Okay, and that's what my first doubt was, and actually proved truth. Okay, because eating wrong food, you know, gluten and other things, you know, and body getting inflamed, intestines getting inflamed, sending vibrations to lungs, under pressure, lungs couldn't anymore cope very well, and panic start. That's not asthma, it's allergic activity on stuff what he ate before. And we start to eliminate, you know, by time, and he start to be lighter, sleepy better, and so on. Key for all sportsmen is to reduce or eliminate inflammation because they're inflamed by work, okay, physical work. And but to eliminate inflammation, that's kind of a key for recuperation.
What would you say to people, Igor, whatever the theory or whatever the method, that the placebo effect, in other words, that if I strongly believe in your methods, I may well start performing better anyway.
That's very correct. If you trust me, what I tell you now, that's your benefits. If you don't trust me, you're not in benefits. But it's kind of freedom of choice, which is key. We're forgetting freedom of choice is eliminate from people. Okay, we need followers. No, followers. Don't think, don't use brain, just follow. Okay. And now people there start to wake up after a while, after this big mess happening in the last 2 years, and start to a little bit open windows and start to realize they can use brain to think logically a little bit what's going on, who pressuring us. Just go to news and actually denying we don't like to see what's happening, kind of never happened. Okay. And like la 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 la, okay? Like Hitler kid, you know. I don't like to hear, I don't like to see. Like monkey, you know, Indian monkeys. But even I don't like to talk because somebody, you know, push me to get these bloody things. Okay. But when you're using brain a little bit and, you know, moving out of it, that's something else.
So I'm guessing you didn't get vaccinated against COVID.
Of course, we are using brain, I'm using knowledge, experience. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of people who are getting issues with vaccines. Okay, not even that last one, the previous one too. Okay, children coming, you know, with issues, neurological issues, getting damaged. Okay, reflection later. We like nice diagnosis after, you know, autism, multiple sclerosis, la 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 la. We like in classical medicine labeling people, put label, you know, and put diagnosis and play around. But we don't like to see cause of it. Okay. A reflection of what's happening.
Back to Novak and his sporting achievements. How long do you think he can keep going?
Well, I think logically, when I was 36, you know, what could motivate me? That's key. Okay, motivation. Okay, now he's, of course, prove everything what he need to prove. Okay, achieve whatever he need to achieve. He's the best on the world ever. Okay, in tennis. Okay, a lot of people then watching him like idol now. Okay, like goal, like I like to be like Novak and so on. But now to get motivation, I think, because he's like winning. He like games. Okay, even if he's playing cards, he like to win. You know, he playing a whatever little ping pong, he like to win. That's kind of his internal gear. Okay, but now having beautiful family and kids and so on, and other I think most important obligation in life, to be parent and to grow up kids. You know, that's, I think he like to spend more time with children. But of course now, to be motivated to train twice per day, that's kind of like something which is always tricky or splitting you or something, you know. But if it's family around him, you know, and motivated to push forward, then I think it'll be fine.
Maybe can he go to Mike? Can he go past 40?
Yeah, my guess is he could be, you know, next 2-3 years still top.
Okay. Thank you, Igor. That's your guess, yes. I guess too, actually. I think he's looking pretty good for another couple of years at least.
Yes.
Igor, listen, wonderful speaking to you today. Thank you for taking some time out from your obviously busy schedule. And take care and have a good day.
Yeah, you too, man. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Igor. Bye-bye.
Yeah, bye-bye.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss out on all things tennis.